Automation Junkie. Welcome back. I'm so excited to talk about virtual assistant niches today. I know that a lot of people may not know what a niche is, but I feel as if it'll be an easy conversation to have because you probably already know the definition, but just never thought that that was the definition. So a niche is something that you're really passionate about. It's something that you believe that you can do every day, and you probably can because you're probably doing it now. For example, if you like to do data entry or calendar management, email management, your niche is probably admin support. If you like to do social media, browsing and engagement, and even making graphics for social media for your own personal account, think about social media management. Now, a lot of people think that it's hard to niche down, and you probably will hear niche down, niche down, niche down a tons of times with all of the different academies that you go through, the courses that you go through. But I can tell you this, you may not find your perfect fit to a niche until you go through them. It is one of the things that I tell people all the time. You will have to experience something and then you'll feel if it fits or not. So hopefully that does fit for you. I actually like doing automation. That's my niche. Automation is something that I've found along the way of doing admin, along the way of trying social media, and along the way of just saying, dag, I don't know what I want to do. So I did some research, but I also feel as if God graced me in the space of understanding how to connect different tools and even streamline businesses through automation. What do I mean by automation? So just as I briefly mentioned, automation is really just helping to eliminate manual labor. So if you're a business owner who has possibly thought about doing too many things at once, like sending an email, sending a contract, sending an invoice, all in one rapid brain with limited time, I would think that automation could be beneficial for you. That means that you're going to take the time to streamline your business, actually strategically create workflows and processes that will help you to have a less manual labor and more of a automated process. I know that a lot of people here may feel as if they just don't get what it is to have a niche, and to even find one may take some time, but I would say join on our community. Our community has some things that I think is beneficial and of value. In there, we give away templates. We give away a lot of things like research and knowledge that we may have that you may find value as well. And we also like to celebrate with virtual assistants who finally get their first client, because we have a video on that. And even trying to make sure that you guys have all that you need to get that to that place of understanding where you're niching down to. I want to talk about my business model and how I got to where I am. So first off, automation is not for the weak in soul, right? You can actually do automation any day, but I think it's about learning the tools that you're using. For example, I use ClickUp every day. And so with ClickUp, there are automation factors that I can do. For example, if I hit a checkbox or a custom field, it can create a task or things like that. It's just eliminating having to create that task manually. And so with my business structure, we help a plethora of people. We help admin support. We have admin clients that we do in admin support. And so we help them do data entry. We help do research products and things like that. But we also help clients with Dubzado setups. So we set their entire Dubzado up. And if you're not familiar with Dubzado, Dubzado is one of my favorite tools. It is used to literally streamline your business. It helps you to send contracts, proposals, and invoices all in one link, one suite, instead of having to send them in three or four different emails. You can also have a workflow set up that is just easily handled by a robot, really, but not really. Think of it as just having more of a straight-lined process. The other thing that I love about automation is that you learn every day. You are always going to find something new that you can automate. For example, I think if you spoke to my director of operations, she'll say that I've changed a few things more than enough times, but I love changing it up because with automation, it just continuously grows and you learn more things every day. I use Zapier to automate some of my tools, and Zapier is one of the most used integrating tools. What it does is it connects different tools to each other. So if you're using your calendar every day, you want to say from your calendar, if you get a new event, send a text message, then you can connect those tools. That's how automation works.
I'm going to actually walk through a live automation that I'm going to create. As you can see on the right side, it is ClickUp. Like I told you guys, I use ClickUp for everything. And I have Zapier on the left side, which is focusing on the creation of the automation. Even though ClickUp has its own automations in-house, it does not do exactly what I want to do. So I'm going to just create a fake one and we can just see exactly what that looks like in my world. So I'm going to start by creating one, and let's just do a calendar invite because it was the first thing that came with my selection. So baseline about Zapier. Zapier is the tool that basically connects multiple different tools. It has over, I want to say, 10,000 apps that you can connect, and you can literally search for those apps in here. It's like over 5,000 and more. So it actually has a ton of them that you can connect. The baseline is that a trigger is basically going to start the automation. It's going to be what happens first. So let's say that if a new event is triggered, a few things you want to know about the triggers. Some of them are instantaneous. You'll see the instant at the side here, and some of them just trigger every 15 minutes or so based on the interval that you are on the plan for. I'm going to just do a new invite. So the new invite is going to be the trigger, and then I'm going to select the actual account that I'm going to be using. So it's going to be my personal account. Going ahead to select now the calendar. So let's choose my personal calendar, all things royal. And then what happens here is that you can actually test it. The fun thing is that testing it literally just gives you like a preview of what it is, and you have options to actually choose the few tests that may have popped up. I'm gonna hit continue, and then now this is the action. So once you've already declared what you want it to trigger from, then let's declare what you want it to do. So I'm gonna say ClickUp. And then we're gonna pause for a second and go into ClickUp, and I'm gonna create a new folder. And the folder, I'm just gonna call it test, right? And so in this folder, you can actually do a few things. You can name the folder, you can actually create a folder from the templates, or you can have fun and just kind of like name the first folder that you want, name the first list that's gonna appear. So I'm gonna say, it's gonna be the fun list. And then what I'm gonna also do here is I'm going to share this with myself and my EA, or I can make it from here private, and then this will just be my own folder to play with. And then the other thing I wanna do is update the tasks, the custom statuses. Sometimes it's boring, and sometimes you need things that are a little bit more direct, and you can literally choose from a few of those, or you can create your own. I'm going to use this one just because I want to. And then what will happen here is that it will do all the things. So you have the ability to change this folder color if you wanted to. My favorite color is purple. And then you have also the ability to change the list view. And I'll make that purple as well. And then you can see here now the actual list itself. Just a baseline, quick overview. You have the option to have different views appear. So you have a list view, which is similar to what you may see in a task list type of view on Monday or Trello or things like that. Then you have the board view, and I'm gonna test it here by just showing you what will show up as a test if I were to actually have it in either the board view or the list view. So you can see it here. You also have the ability to add some other views based on the plan that you're using, and they're pretty fun because you can also embed different types of views. You can make calendars and such and such. Now, to make this really quick and easy, I'm just going to go ahead and just create a task. So I'm going to create a task in this fun view, right? And so I will need to connect all the things first by connecting my ClickUp. The next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and actually set up the action. So I'm going to choose the workspace. In this ClickUp, I only have one workspace that I feel is relevant. However, I have multiple spaces. So you're like, okay, what is a space and what is a workspace? The workspace isn't the entire system that you currently have. So this is, these little items here are workspaces, right? These sections, these mini, I want to call them mini worlds or workspaces. And then inside of those workspaces, you have something that's called a space. So in these spaces, you also have the ability to create folders and lists and documents and forms and all the fun things that go into that process. And then inside of those folders, lists, and documents is going to be tasks. And so it kind of levels out in that way. And I'm going to actually make sure that I tie it out. So right now I'm in the resource hub space. I'm going to select resource hub, and then it's going to ask what folder. Well, I want to actually use the test folder, which we just created. So you have the option to use no folder, which will put it out in the end here, but I'm going to use the test folder. But then it's going to dive in even more, and it's going to say, okay, well, what list do you want? Well, clearly I want to use the fun list, duh. So now when you have the option to actually pull something out, you can say, okay, well, what actual template do I want to use? I'm not going to use a template. I'm actually going to do this from scratch, but you have the option to choose a template. When you choose a template, then it just erases all the other options because it's like, okay, well, we got all we need from that template, so we don't need any other information prior to what we need already. But if we're not going to use a template, then it's going to ask you for all the information. So I'm going ahead and going to make this the task name. So I like to be very specific about what I'm using, what I'm calling a task, because I need it to be direct. Now, one of the options that you have to do is either by adding anything from the data. So as you can see, this imported data is coming from the calendar event, but I can also add something custom here and say, this, I'll just say this. So you can do different signs, different things like that. And that'll be something that you can do to kind of make sure that you're labeling it correctly. And then you can also add different items in here. So I'm going to add the task description to actually be the description to pull in all the details that I need. Now, everything down here, you can see that they're not required. So most times, unless I need to fill it out, then I will. But I'll give you an overview of what this is. Markdown. Well, this just kind of self-explains. It says it's a task description in the markdown format. This isn't. And if you ever wanted some more information, you can always click that little button and it'll tell you what that little indicator means. And then going down here, the assignee's email. So the assignee's email will actually pull from the actual task itself or the workspace itself. However, because the task before it, or I'm sorry, the trigger before it is not a task, it's not going to give you that information as in the data, but you can always just add the assignee's email here if you wanted to manually. And then the assignees, however, will pull from the workspace. So you can see that Marie Lewis, who is me, would be able to be pulled, and you can assign that to me. And then you have the option to choose the status. So in this section, I'm going to actually leave it in open. However, the default would be open already unless I specifically wanted it to be something else. And you have the option to choose tags if you wanted to label it something for, you know, keepsake later searching or something like that. And then you have the priority if you wanted to add that priority. I'll just add urgent for the fun of it. And then the due date here will actually update the due date field. And I'll be fun and just add the due date here. You can see that it's actually a date and a time. So that'll be fun for you to see. Start date does the same thing, but no one really cares about the start date unless you're actually trying to start something on that date. This is going to be the overview of what it looks like prior to it actually being tested. And if you wanted to just shoot it a quick test, you have the option to test and review or test and continue. Testing and continue will basically collapse this action and just test it, but then you'll move on to the option of creating a new action. In this case, I'm going to do test and review. It's going to leave me in this screen to show me the results here that it was actually sent. And it's going to take a second. Boom. So you see a second it took, and it shows that it took a second. However, sometimes ClickUp has a delay. It's a slight delay. And I like to always refresh the screen just to make sure that it does reflect it quick and easy, just like I did. And as you can see here, it reflected it. So you can see that I added that custom layer that says dashy this, and then it added the time and the date perfectly. So that did exactly what it needed to do. And then it also added a priority of urgent. So it pulled over everything I needed, including the actual Zoom information that I also wanted to have in the description. So this is just a quick way to show you guys that automation is fancy, but it's super dope, super cool. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. I know that this was probably a very interesting video for you to see, especially since we're just learning more about how to start, where to start. But again, join our community. I'm looking forward to see more of you in our community just to talk about what's next about being a virtual assistant. See you soon.